This is the final bout, scheduled for one fall with a 45-minute time limit. It is a tag team attraction. Soon to be making their way to the ring area from the South Pacific. At a total weight of 517 pounds, Haku and Tama, the Islanders. At a combined weight of 489 pounds, Rick Martel and Tito Santana, Strike Force.
They're on their feet here in Beantown to welcome Strike Force. Roll them out soon here ringside with Duke Doherty. Look at the looks and determination. Oh, this one's gone already.
They're not wasting any time on this.
As soon as the Strike Force hit the ring, the Islanders attacked. Referee's gonna really have his hands full trying to maintain any semblance of order in this one as they ram Santana and Martel together.
Strike Force kind of struck out.
Oh, they both got caught. As the tide has turned here, where is the Brain?
Brain is on official business in Washington, D.C.
In Washington, D.C.
That's right. I can't disclose what it is.
After all that's gone down between these two teams, I thought for sure he would be here. We saw on national television how these Islanders tried to attack both members of Strike Force individually.
And they did an excellent job of it, by the way.
And they're paying for it right now.
I'm not ruling them
Sooner
out yet.
Sooner or later, you gotta pay your dues. Haku on the receiving end.
That's paying high.
Martel just rams him head first into the steel. Look out. The whole ring just moved about 4 inches. Monkey flip out of the corner. Martel's on fire.
I have to give it to Martel. He is fantastic in that ring.
Santana, second turnbuckle on the inside, drops the elbow. Oh, look at Tama, wasn't paying attention, and Santana just dropped him right on the hardwood floor.
Santana sucking him right on the hardwood floor. Sucking him. He'll pay for that, I'll bet.
Tito now with his arm right there. Big guy going into the tights. Look out. What a move!
Tremendous Andre.
Tito Santana, former Intercontinental Champion, has become the consummate wrestler. He can do it all out there.
I'll have to agree with that, but he's in with two of the toughest tag team people in the business now.
No question about that. They were tough before they went under the tutelage of Bobby the Brain Heenan, and now they are extremely dangerous.
That's the truth.
There's the tag. And the Tama, the speedster of the Islanders, steps in. Look at him go to work. Martel with a leapfrog in reverse. Nice hip knock out of there. And listen to the crowd as he gets struck right over the top there.
What a tremendous drop kick! It knocked him right completely out into the audience.
I believe he rammed his head right into the steel barricades as well. Haku over there in a hurry. There's that drop kick. Whoa, what an impact. And look at that. Tama went right over the barricade and into the ringside.
What a fantastic, unbelievable drop. He's still shaking from that one.
He went over the top, and now his partner just slid him under the bottom. I love it.
His body strength is what's holding him together right now. That's what his training is going to make him get back up into that ring.
Well, they need the Brain right here, right now. I'll tell you that for a fact. A match of this magnitude You know, the winner of this match could easily get a number one shot at the reigning champions, the Hart Foundation. Oh, look at the height on that!
The height! Martel is going bananas in there!
He is on fire, and Tama on the receiving end paying.
Tama is taking...
He wants some mercy. He's not going to get it.
Taking a tremendous beating in there.
Double team swing shot here. Watch out. Double elbow, nailed him.
I'll have to give it to this team. They fast.
Tito continues the onslaught.
That looked kind of low to me.
Didn't appear that way to me. Strikeforce really doing it over here in Beantown on the Islanders.
Sure, with a low blow like that, he knocked the wind right out of him.
Boy, they don't seem to have it all together when the brain's not at ringside.
Now you get off the brain. The brain doesn't need to hold his boys' hands every place they go.
It certainly appears that way to me.
Don't.
Look at the leverage here with a wrist lock. Very painful.
They got the talent and the experience to get out of it, to rebound and come back. Look at that determination.
Well, there's the brains on the part of the Islanders. Shoulder block. Drop down quickly. Look out. Leapfrog up and off. He was waiting for it. One, two, no.
What a sucker punch.
Outsmarted him, did he not?
That was a sucker punch.
Another quick tag made as the quick fiery Rick Martel steps back in.
Two on.
Right back to work on that arm again.
Two on one.
It's a tag match.
Where is the referee?
They tag in and out.
But look at the Samoan with the able to come back with that.
Oh, up to the big elbow drop from Rick Longdon. Beautiful arm drag. As this Boston Garden is erupting here.
Martel is just wound up tonight. Don't worry, though. The Islanders are going to take care of them. They're going to take the wind out of their sails.
And Poirier gets rid of Martel. Didn't have the same effect as it did on Tama. That was a leapfrog by the big guy. Oh, turned around and ran into each other.
That was like running into a brick wall.
Oh, look at this from the outside. Tama going to work on Martel. Santana trying to get over there. Referee stops him. He's got the tag rope right around his neck.
Working over Martel.
Referee turned around. He got rid of that rope.
Tama's doing a fantastic job burning out Martel.
Oh, what a flying elbow by Tama. Well executed. He just turned around. What did he do? He spit.
He did a fantastic job on that flying elbow. I didn't see anybody spit.
He spat right at Santana, which threw him in, and now allows them to double team and choke and do whatever they want to do.
That was just a sweat coming off. They're burning Martel down. Burning him down.
Martel needs to make a tag. Look at the drop kick by Haku. That's getting close to 300 pounds up there.
That's right. Giving him a fist, a foot full of toe.
Vito comes in and makes a save. Well, this one was history. No tag made there as Thomas steps in.
But what's Tito coming in there for?
Duck underneath. Look out. Oh, Martel shot through the ropes.
Look at that. Yeah, they know they got victory. They know they got it. They're going to do a number on this team.
They have Martel in a whole lot of trouble. Why throw him outside the ring? Why not try to beat him? Why am I asking?
The Islanders are going to take it away from the Strike Force. The Strike Force has struck out. Look at that. Victory in their class.
Oh, look at that. Haku on the outside. Ramming Martel into the steel barricade.
Look at these successful Islanders. They look great. Fantastic. Look at that. That's victory, baby. Victory. He knows it. He knows they're going to get it.
Martel in a whole lot of trouble. Needs to get over and make a tag to his partner.
Martel is burnt out. He's had it. They're going to burn him down.
Tama drags him in, reverse knife edge, popped him with it. Tag made to the big guy.
This is it.
Double whip in. Whoa, they nailed him. Putting you all over here. Referee way out of position. Martel reaching down for that little something extra. A long shot. He's trying to find his partner. Now he sees him but couldn't make it.
That Samoan come.
Look out. Power slammer, shoulder breaker, shoulder breaker.
That's it for Martel.
Two count as Martel came out the back door just in time. Drove him down again.
The island has got him.
Oh, a big forward roll, but nobody home. Unfortunately, Rick doesn't have a clue where his corner is.
Martel is dazed.
Now he does. Haku trying to make a tag as well.
Dazed.
Martel's going to make it. He does. And so does Haku. And it's Tito and Tama in there, both on fire. Santana with an Irish whip. Oh, what a backdrop.
Tremendous. Action is unreal.
Palma begging for mercy, but not getting anybody. Tito Santana just on fire. There it was. A point. No. He had it.
Don't worry, the island is not done yet. They're not
finished. He nailed him with a flying elbow and had him, but Haku came in and interfered. It's all broken loose now.
You got
all 4 men inside the ring.
The strike force is going
to be. Here comes Haku. Oh. Give me a break.
What a fabulous move.
Partner to illegal man is in the ring.
Fabulous move by the Islanders. The Islanders are absolutely fantastic, phenomenal.
What a miscarriage of justice here. Haku really did a number on Tito. I'm sure we'll be able to take another look at that one, but right now let's get the official word.
The winners of this bout, the team of Haku and Tama, the Islanders.
The Islanders victorious here. I don't know whether that's going to stand up or not when the president of the World Wrestling Federation, Jack Tunney, takes a look at that. Let's go back and take a look as Tito slaps on the figure four leg lock. Now, note, Duke, they are the two legal guys in the ring, right?
That's right.
Okay, now watch the action. Referee distracted momentarily from the outside. Now, look at this. Here comes a guy not legal in the ring.
Well, what happens whenever one of the strike force gets in the ring? It's legal then, ain't it? Now, look at that.
Look at Haku as he shoves his partner literally out of the ring. Referee turns around. Doesn't even look to see if the legal man is inside the ring.
That's tag team finesse. Tag team finesse.
That's called cheating.
No, it's not. Tag team finesse. That's finesse of tag team.
We'll be back